My blessed gorgeous selves, in last month's ninth of yogi discourses, we followed Yogi Gorakhnath and Yogi Matsyendranath from the Ladies Empire to Girinar Mountain to visit great Yogi Dattatreya, the spiritual master of Yogi Matsyendranath, and from there on to Prayagraj, where Yogi Matsyendranath entered the body of a dead king to bring up a qualified soul. Okay? In between the time of leaving the Ladies Empire and arriving in Prayagraj, some other incidents happened which showed the greatness and coolness of Yogi Matsyendranath, the disciple Yogi Gorakhnath. Yogi Gorakhnath is still renowned all over India, Nepal, and different parts of Asia today. His wisdom, his depth, his sincerity, his service, his love for adventure, and love to serve the suffering humanity, and his dedication to his guru are admired far and wide. His extraordinary birth and achievements are another domain of the wonders of the world, my dear friends. In this talk, we are covering some events which took place before their arrival to Prayag, and supporting understanding will be given after these. The exploits of Yogi Chaurangi Nath, the disciple of Yogi Gorakhnath, will begin. So, my dear friends, now we continue on the exciting pastimes of Yogi Gorakhnath. Yogi Gorakhnath has a great place in the famous yogis of India. His fame has brightened all the directions. His personality is the symbol of greatest power, greatest knowledge, greatest challenge, which is adventurous, which loves the difficulties, loves the danger, loves so much that they have lost their properties of danger, difficulties and problems, and they all have become amalgamated in the joy of his heart. Joy of his life, that is the true picture of Yogi Gorakhnath. Unless you know Yogi Gorakhnath, you have gotten nothing in human life. If you want to have a test of the wisdom of India, you have to know Yogi Gorakhnath. One who does not know Yogi Gorakhnath and is born in India is an Indian just by name, and there is no depth. Because the very prosperity of India is based on wisdom. India stands for the immensity of splendor and vastness of prosperity, which cannot be taken away through the passage of time. Even now, when no one can call it a golden bird, still in third eye view, in true perspective, in which wealth, gold and gems have no value, in wisdom and understanding too, it is. Through understanding, you develop self-awareness, aliveness, peace, placidity, and the power to remain undisturbed in all situations. That is real prosperity, and because India is still rich and opulent and splendorous as far as wisdom is concerned, it is still a golden bird. This wisdom of India becomes a highly glorious with Yogi Gorakhnath. It rose high with Yogi Gorakhnath, and it still exists in the same highly exalted state in the teachings of Yogi Gorakhnath. You say Gorakhnath, and Gorakhnath, and Gorakhnath, and you feel great energy within you. All energies make you violent, but this energy does not. If you become powerful, if you become a man of muscles, you want to show it, you want to slug someone and also be slugged, so that you can show how much strength you have. When you have power, you have some scratching, and that scratching always involves you in the kind of entertainment which involves some trouble. When you have read so many books, when your language is scholarly, when you have an art of oratory, then you develop another itching in your tongue. You want to talk, you want to discuss, you want to argue, you want to win in discussions. This process of arguing leads to either an increased fire of enmity or understanding the facticity, okay? With understanding, new values come to life, then wisdom dawns and self-experience expands. There, then, you have uniqueness. Then you can stand out from the crowd, and the only criterion of a seeker of truth is that he cannot be part of the crowd. He has his own individuality, his uniqueness. He can create a trouble for himself, but he cannot be one with the crowd. That is the sign of a seeker of truth. And if you want to know what is independence, what is freedom, what is fearlessness, what is courageousness, then you must know Yogi Goraknath. With the remembrance and teachings of Yogi Goraknath, India is still prosperous, because when you know Yogi Goraknath, you cannot remain a coward. You cannot remain timid. You cannot be cheap. Immediately you become very expansive. Immediately a great enthusiasm is infused within you, and uniqueness comes to your personality. We have described how Guru Yogi Goraknath entered his lady's empire, and how Mainakini and Yogi Matsyendranath became aware of his presence. How Yogi Goraknath was a guest of the state, and how he convinced Mainakini of the power of his yogic siddhis. Mainakini promised that she would allow Yogi Matsyendranath to leave the empire with Yogi Goraknath. At last, it was decided. Meenanath, the son of Yogi Matsyendranath, and Queen Mainakini would go with them, and at last all the three illustrious yogis came out. Yogi Goraknath walked like a lion. The entire capital was assembled before the royal palace. A grand farewell was given. Silver clothes were spread on the streets for their departure. And when they walked, showers of flowers fell upon them, and loud shouts echoed all around. All glories to Yogi Goraknath, all glories to Yogi Matsyendranath, all glories to Yogi Meenanath. Jai ho, jai ho, jai ho. They walked majestically. All the ladies offered their obeisances, and they proceeded further. When they walked out and entered into the jungle, the ladies became despondent, and Mainakini was heartbroken. She came to the palace, but she was missing Yogi Matsyendranath and Yogi Meenanath so much that tears never left her eyes. Her cheeks were always wet. All the guards and attendants of the royal palace were also miserable, seeing their queen too so upset. Mainakini went deep into the remembrance of Yogi Matsyendranath. She always felt their presence and at the same time absence. She was hanging in between presence and absence. then many times she could not decide, are they present? Many times when she knew they had gone, she would feel sunk in the mud of lamentation, never to come out. Her tormentation was extreme. Seeing her in this state, a celestial being appeared. She said, Mainakini, be aware, only 6 months are left and you will be in your original form. Matsindranath has not gone away, his wisdom is still here. Concentrate your mind on his wisdom and you will be reunited. Mainakini was blessed with the knowledge and became aware. She started following all the concepts, all the precepts very, very carefully. She established a temple of Yogi Matsindranath. Worship was performed daily. Whoever went there attained deep meditation very easily. Meanwhile, Yogi Matsindranath, Yogi Goraknath walked from one forest to another, from one ashram to another, taking dips in the river, one river to another, walking and walking and walking. They came to a forest and Yogi Matsindranath said, my dear disciple, O Goraknath, where are you taking us? My lord, we want to visit the sacred place called Garbhagiri. I feel there are dacoits and robbers. My lord, what dacoits and robbers will do to us? We are yogis, we are holy men. If they will be around, they will come to serve, to bring some food or message. They shall be. Why shall we worry about their being what they are? Matsindranath said, Goraknath, I have some doubt. We should not take any trouble facing a robber. My lord, what is the problem? This is not a way the saint feels. Why there is enmity with a robber? There is a reason, but I cannot say anything, Yogi said. There must be some reason, Goraknath watched. And when Matsindranath went to take a bath, he looked into his bag and there were many, many diamonds and pieces of sapphires and golds and rubies and topaz and pearl. Goraknath thought, this is the thing which is making our spiritual master afraid of dacoits and robbers. Otherwise, there is no reason. So, Yogi Goraknath threw all those gems and sapphires and he put bricks of equal weight. When Matsindranath came and asked for his bag, it was given to him. It had weight, so Matsindranath did not look into it and they all began walking again. It's a great responsibility to check why there is fear. There should not be any fear. There is only joy around you if you are associated and related to a holy man. And fearlessness will come when you have sacrificed, when you dedicate your life on a higher goal. Fearlessness will come upon you only then. So Matsindranath was afraid of the robbers, not because robbers must be feared, but because he had wealth in his bag. The wealth is just a stone. How can it create fear? This is right. Wealth cannot. But attachment with the wealth will certainly create fear. It will make you a puppet of the situation, circumstances and people you are involved with. It happens over and over everywhere in all different parts. part of the condition, over the world. That is why Yogi Matsyendranath is afraid. Yogi Gurudev immediately observed. He was a great psychologist also, psychoanalyst also. Yogi means a great psychologist too. And as they began walking, they said, Gurudev, even if there will be robbers, what will they do to us? The most they can do is give us a dinner in the night and massage our feet when we are going to bed. What else can they do? So what else can they take? Otherwise they will perish. I have power. So Matsyendranath said, no, Gorakhnath, you don't understand. The robbers must be kept away. We must have a distance. I know, my lord, you are not speaking actually. That is speaking which is in your bag. Why don't you throw it away? Throw it away? Mainakini has kept it with such a great devotion. Why to throw it away? It should be thrown because it is just weight, extra weight. You are getting overweight holding it on your shoulder. But I have a desire to feed many, many holy men in a sacred place. But this whole mountain is made of many, many gems and rubies and diamonds and pearls and gold. Oh, what are you talking, my dear disciple? I am not seeing anything like that. But if you will be able to see, then okay, whatever you tell me next, I can follow you. Then Yogi Gorakhnath went on the top of the hill and started passing water abundantly, non-stop for a long time. It drained half of the mountain, and then all that drained part of the mountain was turned into sapphire and rubies and topaz and pearls and gold. When Matsyendranath ji saw, he threw that bag away, and now Matsyendranath's attachment is burnt off, totally finished. The question arises, Yogi Matsyendranath was such a great yogi. He taught Yogi Gorakhnath so much. He gave him all yoga siddhis. He invited all different celestial beings and requested them to bless Yogi Gorakhnath and make him invincible, great yogi. It was Matsyendranath who did it. But then, how Yogi Matsyendranath forgot all these great power and techniques to gain them? How he became attached to the wealth, attached to the Mainakini, attached to Meenanath and so many things? Yes, that is possible, and it can happen with you also. Just like air is pure, clean, beautiful, its nature is always cooling and soothing. But when it passes through a hot country, it becomes hot. And when it passes through the factory of sugarcane jaggery, then it becomes filled with a terrible bad smell. The same way, when it passes through the field where American fertilizers are used, it smells so terrible that your nose starts breaking. When you pass through the huts of the beggars, or the home of a dirty family, or even the home of a materialistic person, then you find the air is suffocating. It has become filled with a bad smell. Air is the same, body is also the same. As the air can carry a filthy smell, so also the body can carry bad smell. The air becomes polluted because wrong person, places and things. It is not its original and authentic nature. The same way, when you attain enlightenment, you become clear like air, you become air.